H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
If you want to ensure that the statement has to be executed for sure, put it inside finally block. Control X, put it inside finally block. So when you put inside this finally block, even if exception occurs, after this catch block, this will be executed for sure. So let me run this. So let me enter ABC. So I can see that only numbers are allowed. Hello, please close and open the application again. So that is the use of having finally block. So finally block, irrespective of the whether exception occurs or not, the statements inside finally block will be executed always. Will be executed. Even if exception occurs or exception doesn't occur. Okay. So let me quickly summarize on what we have discussed on exception handling. Okay. So all the statements wherever you think that we might get some exception, we might get some error, please put them inside a try block and write a catch block. You can write your own catch blocks. For example, you can write a format exception, or you can even catch overflow exception, or you can write any exception. In case if you cannot predict all the exceptions what might occur, you can add a general super exception which is catch exception. So this will catch all the exceptions. And in case if you have other exceptions as well, you have to put this catch exception at the bottom of all the catches, all the previous catches. Otherwise, if you put this at the top, this will catch all the exceptions. So you will get an error. And we have seen finally block. The use of finally block is, if you want to give some messages for the user, you can actually put finally block. And when you run this, the statement inside finally block will be executed irrespective of whether the exception occurs or not. Okay. And one more thing, we have something called format exception. We have given here EX. So why we declared EX is, if you don't want to display your messages, and if you want to display .NET Framework's inbuilt message, okay, in that case, what you can do is, you can delete it, you can write ex.message. Okay, so for example, please try entering smaller numbers. Instead of that, if I want to see ex.message, okay, so here, let me remove this, and I can give here ex.message. So ex is, it will display the user saying, for example, let me try to enter very large number and see what happens. So let me run this. And now I'm entering very large number. See, now the value is either too large or too small for int32. So this is the message which .NET Framework guys have given. So in case if you want to display the message given by .NET Framework, you can actually use this ex variable. So you can actually use ex.message. But sometimes, most of the times, we'll not use this ex.message. We'll only use our own message because sometimes customers might not know what is int32. Why should I show this to customer? Say, for example, if the customer enters like this, why should I show a message like this? int32 is too small, too large, or something. So we don't want to show this type of message for the user. So user wants some very friendly messages. So in that case, you will not use this EX. You will write your own message saying like value is too large. So you can write like this, value is too large. Try smaller numbers. Okay, so this is the use of this variable EX. Okay, so if you want to display .NET friendly messages, .NET error messages which is given inbuilt by .NET, you need to use ex.message. Or if you want to write your own message, you need to write whatever message you want. So also, if any exceptions occurs in one statement, the statements Okay, so I'm getting a message from one of the students saying like my display is coming very late than my voice. So how about others? Are you able to understand properly and is it clear? So tell me if it's clear. Okay, you are seeing a delay, is it? Okay, so my voice is coming first and then you're seeing the, okay. So, but are you able to understand? Okay, so how many of you got this concept? Okay. So just a second. So I need to check my, okay. So let me check this. In case if the speed becomes slow, right? So then also this issue might come. Yeah, I think there is some problem with my internet. So how about voice? Okay. Okay. So looks like there is some, okay. Yeah, so looks like there is some problem with my internet speed today. My internet speed is a bit less. Okay. So okay. Okay. So what I'll do now is maybe we'll, I wanted to take for longer time. I need to restart my modem, but if I do that, there'll not be anyone to make me as presenter. Okay, so if I disconnect and join back, right? So there should be someone from H2K who makes me as presenter. So might be difficult. Okay, so I'll do one thing. So yeah, I'll do one thing. I'll make one of you as host and presenter. So when I join back, you have to make me as host and presenter again. Is that fine? I'll be joining back within 3 minutes. I'll be joining back. I'll just restart my modem. That will actually restore the speed. Is that fine? Hello? Yeah. So yeah. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll make Babita as presenter and I'll make her as host. So in case if I cannot join back within let's take within 5 minutes. So change role to I'm making presenter in case if I cannot join back 5 minutes, so we will continue in the next class. Okay, so I'm making her presenter. Just a second, even that is taking a lot of time, making presenter. So Babita, like, you should not disconnect before I join, otherwise like the session will be ended. Okay, so I made you as presenter and I'll change your role to host. Okay, so now you are the host. So Babita, so what I'm doing now, I'm just disconnecting myself. I'll be joining again. So in case if you don't see me within 5 minutes, we will continue in the next class. So is it fine with all of you? Is it fine with all of you? Hello? Okay. Okay, so I'm disconnecting myself, so I'll be back within 5 minutes. Okay. Okay. So now I think you'll be seeing, you'll be seeing the screen properly and also my voice. And see, now I just minimized Visual Studio. So what you're seeing now? Hello? Yeah, so now the speed is better. I just opened Visual Studio again. Okay. Now, so I'll again mute all of you. Okay. So now let me quickly summarize on why we need this exception handling, and then let me quickly summarize on this exception handling. So exception handling is used to catch the possible exceptions which might occur, so that users will not see any error messages, or users will not get annoyed by seeing like overflow exception, or users will not see any messages, unnecessary messages. So in that case, you will add a try block. All the statements wherever you can see the possible type of possible exceptions, add that inside a try block, and we'll add catch exception. So we can catch different types of exceptions which we have, and exception ex is a super exception. And you can actually display console.writeline inside this catch block. You can display the exception whichever we have, like for example, you can write your own exception values too large or try smaller numbers like this. And if you want to use inbuilt message which is given by Microsoft.net, so you can use this ex.message. So when you use ex.message, so for all the exceptions, Microsoft has given its own message. So in case if you don't want to write this exception by yourself, you can use that inbuilt message. So if you want to use inbuilt message, but the inbuilt messages are a bit technical, so you can only be, that can be used by developers but not for the end customers. Okay, so for example if I run this, okay, so if I run this now I'm putting a breakpoint. So let me put a breakpoint in this all the three exceptions. So I'm just putting a breakpoint here for all the three exceptions. Now I'll enter a large value. So let me run this, and here I'm entering large value, very large value, and click on enter. So now exception is occurred, I mean it came here. So when I move the mouse here, I can see this ex message. So as a developer, I can see that, okay, the exception which I got is value is too large or too small. So developers can use this message, ex message, so that they can actually understand about the exception. So this is specially used when you are using some when you want to understand what is the exception that occurred. Okay, so ex exception is the one which will show inbuilt message, inbuilt .NET framework message for this type of exception. Okay, so most of the times we will not use ex.message, we will only use our own messages, like value is too large or too small, or only numbers are allowed. So we will not here, for example, see the message for format exception. You will never understand if you see this. So now if I run this, if the customer enters ABC here, and press enter. So you cannot understand this message. Input string was not in correct format. So do you think customer will understand like input string was not in correct format means, do you think customer will understand like, okay, I should enter integer, by mistake I gave some other string or something. So user might not understand. So in that case, you need to give your own message instead of using .NET Framework's inbuilt message. Okay, so here we need to give proper message saying like only numbers are allowed. So now you understood what is the use of this exception EX, this message. If you want to use inbuilt exception message, you have to use this exception, or else you can leave it. You can just give exception, overflow exception. You don't need to give that EX. You can only put only till here. Okay. So here I'm using EX. Okay. So this is about exception handling. So I think hope all the points are clear in this exception handling. So now, any questions in exception handling? So I'm asking question, what is the use of finally block? What is the use of finally block? Hello? What is the use of finally block? I'm not seeing any response. So what is the use of this finally block? Yeah. Perfect. So I got couple of responses. I want to see the response from all of you. So the use of this finally block is, yeah, irrespective of the exception, if you want to ensure this every time, then we use finally block. Okay. So this is about exceptions. So which is super exception? Yeah, so exception, only exception, this is super exception. So always you need to ensure that super exception should be there at the end. Okay, yeah, super exception will catch all the exceptions. So I'll tell you one example. So I went to one exam, .NET exam, where they have given like this. Okay, and then you will not see this red lines and all, so it will be there in Notepad. For example, the code is like this. Okay, so especially like if you do any Microsoft certification for C# or something, you will see some type of code like this. What is the output of below code or something like this. So you will see code like this, and for all the lines they will give line numbers. Okay, and they will ask you, which line do you think, what is the output of this program? Sorry. So they will ask you, what is the output of this program? So they will tell you one simple scenario as well. They will tell you, I enter A value as 5, I enter B value as 0. So what is the output for this? The first option will be, they will have added one more here. Okay, so the first option will be here. Let me give here. Okay, now question to all of you. I'll give this code to all of you, and then I'll also tell user will enter. So here, user will enter A as 5 and B as 0. So what is the output for this program? So this, like this, you will get a question. So what is the answer for this? So is it some exception occurred, or is it only numbers are allowed, or is it value is too large, or try smaller numbers, or is it none of this? So first option will be some exception occurred, and second option will be only numbers are allowed, and third option will be value is too large or too small, and fourth option will be none of this. So what is the output for this program? All of you enter your choice, only choice. Okay, so enter your answer. I need the answer from all of you. I need your response. So for those who answered one, can you now realize like what is the flow of these exceptions? Which is there at the top? Exception? What type of exception is there at the top? Super exception. So what do you think if I compile this, what will happen if I compile this code? If I compile this code, do you think that will generate exe? That will not generate exe. If I compile this code, I will get error. See, for example, if I have this code, so I'll get error saying like there is super exception which catches all the exceptions. So what is the answer now? All of you, please try to understand. Answer now is none of this. The answer is 4, but I answered some exception occurred, because that time I'm not sure that even I felt like this is not format exception, this are not overflow exception, this exception will be caught, and I thought like this will print some exception occurred, but that is not correct. So when you have this catch exception EX at the top, when you compile this code, this will not compile. Your dotted framework compiler will not compile it. It will throw compilation error. It will compile it, but it will not create an exe, because it will throw compilation error, because this catch exception EX should be at the end. Okay, so please, when you are answering, please be very careful, because the questions will be in a way that it will confuse you, and you will come out saying like the paper is so easy, but you will see the result, you are not selected. So even I felt for a couple of times like that. So I got a question saying like, then for any program with super exception will produce exe. No, it's not like that. When you get any compilation error, that will not produce an exe. So if you put this at the bottom, of exception, then it is correct. Okay, so the reason why this has to be at the bottom, because there is no point of having these exceptions when this exception is catching all the exceptions. Okay, so in that case, you need to put this at the bottom. Or you need to remove these exceptions. Either put this super exception at the bottom, or remove this sub exceptions. Only have the super exceptions. Now what happens? When you add this super exception at the top, it will not produce an exe. So for example, see, now I got a question saying like, when you add this at the top, do you think that will not produce exe? Yes, it will not produce. When you get a compilation error, it will not produce an exe. For example, let me save it and let me open containing folder and go to this folder, bin folder, debug folder. Let me delete this exe. Okay, so now let me rebuild it. So let me rebuild the solution. Right click on this, rebuild. So now I'm getting an error, a previous catch clause. So what is the error I'm getting? So this is perfect error what I'm getting. So for these two exceptions, I'm getting here a previous catch clause already catches all exceptions of this type or super type. So no point of having these two, because already an exception is catching all this. So remove this or put that catch exception at the bottom. So that is the exception which I'm getting. So now right click on this, open containing folder, go to bin folder, debug folder. I'm not seeing exe. I'm not seeing that console application 48.exe, because if any exception occurs, or if I see any, I mean, if any error occurs, compilation error, this is a compilation error. So when any compilation error occurs, it will not generate exe. So what you need to do now, you need to correct the error. Either move this to the bottom or remove these two. Okay, so let me move this to the bottom. And now rebuild it. Now rebuild succeeded. Now I can go to open containing folder. I can go to bin folder. I can see the exe file. Now you understood. So now all of you, now what is the answer for this when I have this exception at the top? I have this exception EX at the top. What is the answer now? So the answer is 4. Not one. The answer is 4 because this will throw compilation error. Now if I have like this, now what is the answer? Now you are right. So this is not format exception, this is not overflow exception. So this will actually go to exception EX and show you some exception occurred. So please be very cautious while giving any exam. So please try to analyze the code and then understand it. So always ensure that your exception EX should be there at the bottom. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So this is about exception handling. So any questions about exception handling, or is it very clear, or is it clear? So how do you rate yourself, your understanding in exception handling from 1 to 5? 5 being very clear. Okay. So this is about exception handling. Now, shall we continue or we'll stop here? So I got a message, I got a question saying like, I will explain, I got a question saying like, can you explain what is the difference between compile time error and runtime error? Okay. And I got another question saying like, if divide by zero exception is there, so it will show that message. Okay. Now, if divide by zero is there, okay, see here, if divide by zero is there, what happens? It will go to where? It will go to which section? If I get divide by zero exception, it will go to super exception, because it is not format exception, it is not overflow exception. So it will go to here and it will put ex dot message. So we don't know what is the .NET framework inbuilt message. So let's try to see what is .NET framework message for divide by zero. Let me run this and try to enter 6 and 0. See now, attempted to divide by 0. Yeah, this is giving very user friendly message. EX dot message is showing very user friendly message. Attempted to divide by 0. Hello, please close the application and open again. This is very good, right? So, yeah. So, is this your question, Babita? Yeah. So this is about divide by 0 exception.
What I was asking is like, if I put like divide by zero, like in the catch,
yeah,
divide by zero,
yeah,
so it will show up that one, right?
Correct. It will not show the super exception that time. So for example, if I write catch here and if I write divide by zero exception, and if I write here, for example, console dot write line, and if I write here like denominator cannot be zero. So in this case, if I run this, it will not go to exception. Okay, I need to put semicolon here. So let me run this now. So enter first number 6, enter second number 0. See now, it's coming, denominator cannot be 0. So it is not going to super exception because already this exception has been caught, divide by 0 exception. Okay, only in case if any exception occurs other than these three exceptions, then only it will go to super exception. Okay, is this your question, Babita?
Yes, thanks.
Okay, so I got one more question saying like, can you please explain compile time error and runtime error? Okay, so I'll explain compile time error and runtime error. Okay, now let's take one example where I'm actually forgetting to put a semicolon. Okay. So I forget to put a semicolon. Now if I try to compile this, so I'm getting an error saying semicolon is missing. So this is called compilation error. So when I compile the code, if I see any error, that is called compilation error. Okay. Now just when you compile, if you see any error, that is called compilation error. So now I'll tell you what is runtime error. So runtime error is something like when we execute the code, in compile time we will not get the error, only when execution we'll get the error. Say for example here, instead of 2 in 32, as good as this, for example, let me remove these exceptions, all the exceptions. Okay, so let me comment out this, and also let me comment out this try block. Okay, so now if I try to enter, say for example, 0 for B. Now, for example, I am running this. Now I enter first number 6, I enter second number 0. Now I'll get some error or I'll get some exception. This is called runtime error. See now. This is called runtime error. So compile time errors are something which occurs when you compile the code, and runtime errors are something which occurs when you execute the code. So to overcome runtime errors, you have to write your code with all the exceptions. You have to catch all the exceptions, then you will minimize your runtime errors. Okay. So is it clear now, Sandhya? What is the difference between compile time error and runtime error? Yeah. Okay. So any other questions you have? Okay. So today, yeah, but there is nothing to confuse. So okay. So compilation error is blindly, you can think when you compile something, if you get any error, that is called compile time error. Okay. So for example, anything, for example, instead of putting A by B equal to C or anything, for example, if I forget to declare C, if I forget to declare variable C, now if I try to compile it, I'll get an error, as simple as that. So this is a compile time error. C does not exist in the current context. So this is a compilation error. Okay. So that is the difference between compile time error and runtime error. Okay. Yeah. Now, can we compile all exceptions and write as one? Can we compile? I got another question saying like, can we compile all the exceptions and write as one? So in that case, you can use super exception if you want only one exception instead of all these exceptions. Okay. So not sure is this a question. So okay. So Padmini, can you explain your question? You can unmute yourself.
I was just thinking like this overflow and divide by zero and all those things. I just write a catch, one single catch, and use the object exception dot overflow or divide.
Okay.
Using if and or all those things, and then.
I got it.
Something like that.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Okay. I got your question. So yeah, let me mute you. Yeah. So I got the question. So what is she saying is, okay. So what I can do here is I can remove all these things. So let me comment out all these things. And what she is telling is in this, actually we can write like this. So we can write exception. So switch. Someone is supposed to explain switch today, right? Who is that? Yeah, we can do that. Parimala. So how we need to do is, if ex dot ex exception is first, say for example divide by zero exception. So you can write here saying like this is of console dot write line second number. Okay, so something like this you can write. So let's run this and see whether we'll get this or not. So let me rebuild it. Okay, so I will enter divide by zero exception. So let's see whether second number cannot be zero will come or not. So let me run this. I'm entering 6 and 0. Sorry, I should have entered, press enter. So run this. I'll tell you what is this is operator and all. For now, don't worry. So 9 and 0. So second number cannot be 0. So this is how you can write a if condition. If this exception is divided by 0 exception, or you can write here else if ex is overflow exception. You can actually write here console.write line. You can write here number is too large. and like this you can actually write, for example, if you write here else if ex is what is the other one, format exception, you can write here console.writeline only numbers are allowed. Okay, so and you can write here else, so instead of this console.writeline message you can actually write here else. Okay, so I'll tell you what is this is operator later, but yes as okay, so I think doing this is more efficient, because here you need to check for if else if like this. So imagine if the exception which you are getting is the last one. So if you have catch block, directly you go to exception. Okay, so normally this way is better. Writing like this is better than writing if else like this. Okay, so any other questions? So all of you, any questions? Like so if you don't have questions, like we can stop here. So
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.